What's up, you guys, and welcome back to my channel. For those that are new here, hi, my name is Rochelle, and I like to make thrifting and fashion videos along with a little bit of beauty and just sharing my life with you guys over here on my little corner of the internet. As you guys can see from the thumbnail and the title, today I am doing my top 10 thrifted items of 2019. Honestly, you guys, it was hard for me to just pick 10. I think I made a list of like my favorite stuff over the last like few weeks, and there was like probably around like 18 to 20 items on there, and I slimmed it down to 10 plus one bonus item that kind of counts. And so I figured I'd just go over everything with you guys today. I have a little home decor, I have accessories, I have clothes, I have all the things. So let's get ahead and get right on into it. All right, you guys, I'm not gonna do this in any particular order just because that would just be like way too hard for me. It was hard enough just to get down to 10. So these are just gonna be in any random order. I love all of these. It's like children. You can't say that you just like one the best. It's like, I love you all. You know what I mean? First one I'm gonna get to, just because I think it's the largest item that I have here and I wanna talk about it really quickly. It is this guy right here. It is a real sheepskin rug. I would never buy this new, ever. And honestly, when I saw it in the thrift store, I didn't think it was real. I actually thought it was faux. And then when I got home, I noticed that it had this tag right here on the back. And it is 100% sheepskin. I got this, I think, for like $9.99. And I was so excited just because I definitely do like the look of sheepskin rugs and cowhide rugs. For those of you guys that are not comfortable thrifting real fur items, I totally get it 100%. For me personally, I am okay with it just because it's already been used and I would never buy it new. So for me, I'm okay with it, but if you guys are not, I totally understand and I completely respect that. This one is right in front of me, so I figured I would quickly show it to you. This little guy is a Gucci bracelet from 1970, and I don't think that I picked this up at a Goodwill, I don't know, maybe like 4 to 5 months ago, kind of like at the end of summer, I would say. It looks like this. On the sides of it, it just has a little like snakeskin rim, and then in the front, it has the two little Gucci G's in the front there. I don't think that they realized that this was Gucci. It just looked like a kind of like a plain little gold bracelet or like wrist cuff. And so they only priced it, I think, at around $7 or $8. And I wasn't sure if it was authentic Gucci. Honestly, I thought it was fake. So when I got home, I just kind of like looked it up and it turns out it is. So I was so excited to get this little guy. And I love it. I think that most of the stuff that I've picked up from the thrift store that does look designer is most of the time a replica, but this one is real. And so I was so excited, so it definitely made it into my top 10. These next two are also little vintage items. This one right here, if you guys have been around for a little while, you guys have seen this before. This is my little grandma purse. You guys always make fun of me for liking like grandma type items. I don't know what it is. Like, I feel like old things or like grandma chic is a thing. And I just really loved this little purse. It has the carpet print on the fabric, and on the top it is just a little gold chain and it has the little clasp. I especially love the tag. Something about that little vintage tag just is so cute to me and I absolutely love it. Honestly, I don't use it that much, but whenever I look at it, it just makes me happy and it's funky, it's cute, it's unique, it's different. Looking at all of my items together, I definitely realized that I like very different items. Like, there's a lot of things that I get from the thrift store that are more practical and I wear on a normal basis, but the things that are my favorites end up being like the pop-out pieces or the very different items that I end up loving. This was by far my favorite pair of denim I have ever thrifted in my life, I would say. It was such a come up. I love them so much. I honestly don't wear them that often, but it doesn't mean I don't love them. And they are the bell bottoms that I found when I was in Las Vegas. I got them from Deseret Industries. Hold please. They look just like this. And then here is the back. I know that they don't look like much just holding them up, but when these are on, they're absolutely adorable. Just where the pockets are, how high-waisted they are. They have a lot of cute little like lines and buckles and stripes, and they are bell bottoms. I save my favorite things for like special occasions. I don't know if you guys do that too. Let me know in the comments down below if you guys save like certain outfits for like, I don't know, you're doing something like special. And until then, I just stare at it and love them. But yeah, so I love these. They're so cute, vintage. And I feel like bell bottoms are really like on their way back in. So I'm excited for that. You guys have probably seen this before, and I totally understand if it's not everyone's style, but I absolutely love this stupid little purse, and I know it's like very like costume, jewelry, costume type of little purse, but I got this in Las Vegas, which is very fitting for what it looks like. Just this little chain bag, kind of like an envelope style. The inside is just a super bright orange, which I think is such a cute accent, and then it does have the gold little strap. It's just very different, funky, weird, cute. I like to wear it when I'm wearing all gold jewelry and like a little black dress, going out with my friends when they are in town. And something about this stupid little bag I love so much. It's so cute. So thank you, Las Vegas, for this awesome find. That's like one of the things I love about thrifting in other places is that you find things that are very true to that city or that location. I wish I could thrift all across the United States. That would be so fun. Or just all across the world, really. All right, you guys, this little one is one that I actually picked up in my hometown, and it is just this little brown Western belt. It has this beautiful buckle detailing and all of the little like studs all around. I saw this as I was leaving the thrift store, and I walked out to the car and I told Everett, hold on, I have to go back in there. There's a belt that I have to have. And so I ran back in and got it because I figured it would be gone if I left it. It is rather beat up and worn, but that's something I definitely like about it. Something about when something is really worn in, it feels like it's more special to me, and it also feels like I can wear it and I'm not scared to mess it up. You know what I mean? I got this little guy, it was $12, and it is genuine leather, and I don't know. I just think it's so cute. Sticking with the Western cowboy theme, I picked up these little black boots right here when I was thrifting in Phoenix, Arizona. I'm pretty sure is where I got these. I went on a road trip this summer. I ended up going to Los Angeles, Phoenix, Palm Springs, New Mexico, and Texas. It's all kind of a blur since we went to all those cities like back to back, but I'm pretty sure I picked them up in Phoenix and they were like $3 or $4. It's the first time I had ever been to a Savers, and I feel like Savers has much better prices on shoes than my local Goodwill. I love that they have this cute little like round buckle here with the straps, and they're kind of slouchy on the top, and they come to the really sharp black point, and they have a little bit of a block heel. They are a little bit big for me, but I just wear multiple socks and I deal with them being a little bit big. I'm so glad that I picked them up. This next one is another clothing item, and it is this gorgeous silk dress. It is a slip dress, so I found it in the slip section or like the lingerie section. I feel like it's really hard for me to find the perfect slip dress because I don't like really bright colors. I like neutral colors, and I want it to be very elegant and classy and not like too cheesy looking. And I feel like some of the slip dresses in the lingerie section can look a little bit cheesy, in my opinion, but this one was absolutely beautiful. Like I said, it's 100% silk, and it's very, very long, and it's not too revealing. It does have the V-neck in the front here, and there's just something about this one that the color just spoke to me as soon as I saw it. I was so excited. I found this, you have no idea how excited I was. I just think it's so beautiful, classy, elegant. It was everything that I wanted in a slip dress to be that I hadn't found before. Once I got this dress, I actually did an entire photo shoot with one of my best friends, Ari, who is a photographer, and she shot me in this gorgeous dress, and I will just cherish those photos so much just because I like this outfit so, so much. This next one is also really fun. I got it recently on a day that I wasn't filming while I was thrifting, and it is this Hot Kiss. So it's kind of like an old, I don't know if that's like 90s or early 2000s, corduroy jumpsuit. This is so fun. It doesn't look like much, but when I wear this, it's so stinking cute. My husband always compliments me whenever I put it on. He loves it. It looks really, really boring, but whenever I put this on, I feel just like sexy, confident, fun, different. I like to look unique. Sometimes I feel like when you go out, everyone kind of like looks the same. I like to wear very different things, as you guys probably can tell by my taste. And yeah, whenever I wear this, I feel like it's funky and different and super cute. It just fits my body well. The only thing I would say is I wish that it was long sleeve because I wanted to wear it this winter, but I can't find a cute jacket to pair with this. So I ended up not wearing it and taking it off. I guess it's more of like a spring and fall kind of jumpsuit. Might be a little bit hot for the summer. I got this at my local Auburn Goodwill. All right, you guys, and then this is number 10, and you guys probably have seen this because I got it within the last like month and a half. It is this super long leather jacket,
kind of like a suede-y leather on the outside, and then it has the crazy faux fur like pieces on the front and on the arms. And it is from Wilson's Leather, which you guys let me know is a really good brand. I absolutely love this. It was originally $17.99, but I got it on a half off day, so I feel like I got a really, really good deal on it. And there's something just so like fun and funky and sassy about this coat that I absolutely love it. I haven't had that many like fun events to wear it out to, but I definitely hope that I will here in the new year. I saw a different YouTuber that thrifted one that was almost exactly like this, and I loved it so much that I like wished that I would find something similar, and then like a few weeks later, boom, there it was. So I feel like I manifested this little jacket right here. All right, you guys, that was 10, but I do have one bonus, and I'll tell you why. Let me grab them. These are my Doc Martens. I feel like they count and they don't count at the same time, and let me tell you why. I ended up thrifting a pair of Doc Marten shoes, and I showed it in one of my hauls here on YouTube, and one of you lovely subscribers messaged me and said that you had a pair of Doc Marten boots that didn't fit you and that you would trade me for the ones that I have, which worked out perfect because the ones that I had thrifted didn't fit me. They were too big, so I was just going to sell them on my Depop or Poshmark. I was just excited to find Doc Martens in the thrift store. They were the shoe kind. Since yours didn't fit you and I was looking for boots, you ended up trading me, so I didn't pay for these myself. They were absolutely brand new when one of you guys ended up sending them to me and us trading, so I was so excited. So I feel like it kind of counts as thrifting because I traded the ones I got at the thrift store and I didn't pay for these ones, but I guess it's technically not thrifting because I didn't find them at the thrift store and they were brand new. I don't know, let me know if that counts down below. That's why I ended up making this one a bonus number 11, but I absolutely love these Doc Martens. I feel like I'm never gonna be able to go back. I absolutely love them, and I honestly would probably pay full price for another pair now. If I didn't get these over the last year, I probably would have asked for them for Christmas because I'm obsessed. I love them so much. They are still a little bit stiff on me. I've been trying to break them in and do a lot of like the leather conditioners and really break them in. They are slightly a little bit stiff, but I love them so much and I was so excited. So thank you so much to whoever ended up swapping these for me. I'm so happy and excited and I love this so, so much. All right, you guys, this was probably a pretty quick little video, but I just wanted to get it out for you guys before I ended up starting all of my Utah thrifting videos. Those are coming to you next, but I figured since it was the end of 2019 and the start of 2020, I wanted to say Happy New Year's. What are some of the favorite things that you guys ended up thrifting in 2019? What do you hope to find in the thrift store in the future? Like I said, I found that jacket after I feel like I manifested it. So I feel like it's always good to think about what you want, and sometimes you end up finding it. I truly believe in the power of positivity and the law of attraction. So what do you guys end up wanting to find this year? I definitely have a wish list that I'm hoping to thrift in the future. And yeah, I think that that is it. I love you guys so, so much. Happy 2020. I hope you guys all had a safe New Year's Eve and New Year's, and I'll see you guys very, very soon in my next video. Bye. Utah thrifting coming next. Bye.